A celebrated part of Pittsburgh is celebrating its 100th season.
The miniature railroad at the Carnegie Science Center takes people back in time to a different era of Western PA.
Yeah, it is very special. Chris Hoffman explains how it's lasted and continues to thrive a century later.
For a century now, millions of kids and adults have been taking the step back in time to the turn of the 20th century in Western Pennsylvania.
My father used to take us over to the Buell Planetarium when we were little tykes and waiting in line at Christmas time to see the trains.
The display started in Brookville, Jefferson County, before going to the Buell Planetarium in the 50s and the Science Center in the early 90s. That's when Al Bielek became a volunteer.
There's a lot of things people that live here in Pittsburgh didn't know were part of Pittsburgh, and I enjoy showing them that, telling them the history about that.
Now, almost three decades later, he's seen new models added, many which take him back to his childhood in the region.
My favorite part is Forest Field. As a kid, I grew up going to Forest Field to watch the Pirates years ago.
And even today, with the advent of technology and gizmos, children and adults still flock to see the trains, the animated figures, and the details that go into every model.
The kids get so excited to see something that they know so well and they see every day, depicted here in the miniature railroad and village.
The display, which is bigger than several homes across the region,
this is about 2,300 square feet,
has survived one century and hopes to live for another one.
It's truly such a special gem here of the Pittsburgh region that I think it truly deserves to last another 100 years, if not longer.
I have to go back. I have to spend time with the people that come through, because that makes it all worthwhile, really.
Chris Hoffman, KDKA News.